for guys who are in prison, in a max security prison, it's pretty obvious they need discipled, you know, to the outside world. You know, why are churches or groups wanting to come in? Because they're like, oh, these guys are messed up. They're obviously bad people. Mm-hmm. They obviously need help. They obviously need to change their ways. Mm-hmm. And so we'll gladly, you know, most of the time, joyfully give them that discipleship. But do we look around? This is a statement, the extreme statement. But do we look around at our local normal churches and look at those people and say the same thing? I think maybe we should. Mm. Like, these people are obviously messed up. They, and I'm not talking about the prisoners, I'm talking about the normal congregation. Yeah. They obviously need help. They're obviously twisted. They're obviously one step away from committing crimes, whether they realize it or not. But we don't. We think, oh, well, you know, they got a big house, a nice car. They're fine.
Well, let me add another layer to that.
They come to our church. They're fine. But maybe they're not.
I think you're right. And I also think one of the differences, it's not just the difference that we on the outside think they need it. So the guys on the inside know they need it, and they're receiving it. Because I would say there are some churches that have tried. And I remember we had a guy that was a mentor in our program, and he was a pastor for 40 years, and he's retired now. And he made this comment. We had him teach for us once. He said, it's hard to be a leader today because followers are so fickle. Mm-hmm. And those people who don't see the need for it, because they got the nice house and the big yard and all that, they don't see the need for it. And if they're kind of being taught these things, then maybe they're even being made to feel, you know, they feel guilty. They're being convicted. I'm not saying that the people are putting guilt trips on them, but they're feeling the conviction. They just go to another church. Mm-hmm. They just roll up the street and go, oh, I don't
know. Well, I want to say one thing just for clarity's sake, like every church or volunteer going into a jail or prison doesn't have discipleship on their mind. I would say it's quite the contrary. It's let me just go in here and evangelize and get these people saved, and then it's on to the next one.
It's hit and run. Okay.
So there's no discipleship on the mind of most people going in. It was just a few individuals that, by the grace of God, I happened to encounter, and I'm still involved in their lives and they in mine currently. But to your point, like, the difference between the sinner living in a big house that has a nice job and a nice family and the guy that's in prison is that obviously the guy in prison, his sin was breaking the law. And maybe the guy in the big house and the family, their sin isn't breaking the law. Or just haven't been caught, but they're still guilty in the eyes of God, you know, and their sin will lead them to a path of destruction lest they have Christ as their